What's going on, guys? Today I'm going to show you how to test your React applications using React Testing Library. React Testing Library is an alternative to Enzyme. Rather than focusing on implementation details, it focuses more on how the user would see and use the application. It's typically used with Jest, which is a testing framework. It helps structure your tests and lets you run your tests with npm run test, among other things. Both of these work so well and are so widely used that they come with Create React App right out of the box, so you can start testing your application without installing or configuring either of those. So I have this super complex application where you type in a username and it'll display the username. It greets the user. So very simple, obviously, but we can get some real world testing in with this application. We can test that these elements are here. We can type into the input. We can click the login button and change the state and change the view and test that that all happened correctly. So we'll be able to cover a lot of the real world use cases for React Testing Library. If we look in the code here, I have some local state for user and login. If there is a user, I'll render the user and greet the user. If there's not a user, I will render the login form, which just has the label of username and an input where you can type in your username and click login to log in and sets the user. And then I'm either rendering the user or the login form. So this is the component that I want to test. I have my layout component here. So we'll add a layout.test.js. When you run npm run tests, it'll go through all your files with a test file extension and run the tests in those files. So we'll need to import React from React, since we're testing React components. We'll need to import some named imports, do a render and screen for now from testing library React, and we'll have to import the component that we're testing. So the structure of the tests will consist of two main parts. You'll have your describe function, and you'll send in a string. And I'll typically use the name of the component that you're testing. So when you have a bunch of tests with a bunch of different components, you will see this string and you'll know which component that passed or failed the test. So that'll be a string and then a callback. And then you'll have this test function where you'll pass in a string describing a certain test. For us, we'll do user logs in and user name is displayed, which also gets a callback function. And then we'll write our tests in here. So this describes the test suite, and then the test here is the test case. So you'll have one test suite, and then you could have, see if I do shift option down, you could have multiple tests inside one test suite. Multiple test cases, that is. So first thing we'll want to do is render our component. And now we can test for certain things inside that component. So we have some text on the screen, this username. So first things first, we can just test that this username text is on the screen. So we'll do an expect and then we'll pass in an element or some text that we want to check for. This is where we'll use that screen from React Testing Library. We'll do a screen.getByText, and we'll say username, and we'll do a dot to be in the document, which is a function. So right now we're just rendering our component, and then we're expecting, we're grabbing this username text, and we're expecting that to be in the document. So if we go down here, run npm run test, test passed. You see it says layout, that's what we're putting in this describe right here. So when you have multiple tests, you can see which ones are doing what. And then this is your test case, which it also puts there. Another cool thing you can do is debug function, which will show you the document that you're working with. So if we save that, this is automatically running already. So debug is like the console.log for testing. So it shows our body tag, the main tag, the form, got our label and input, our button. So that can be useful as well. I'll quit that for now. So the thing with getByText is it has to be exact. So if we were to take that out, it fails. So what you can do is instead of passing in a string, you can do a regular expression where you just type username with another slash, and then maybe pass in the I flag to let them know that you're not worried about whether it's uppercase or lowercase. Hit save, and it passes because there is a match for username. And notice we keep putting screen.getByText or screen.debug. You can also destructure this render function, which will also give you these, so you don't have to put screen dot whatever. So we want the getByText. And another one you can do is getByLabelText. So we'll get rid of the screen here. And when we do getByLabelText, we can target this label that's associated with this input, which will give us this input. So if I do a debug getByLabelText, and we pass in username, I'll have to grab that out of here as well. If we run that, you'll see that it's giving us that input. And so now what we can do is also type into this input. So we'll get rid of the debug, and I'll save this to a constant. I'll say username input. And to type, we'll have to do, we'll have to pull in a user event, import user event from testing library user event. We'll do user event dot type, and we'll pass in the element that we want to type into, which will be the username input. You could also just do the getLabelByText right there too, of course. And then a comma, and then a string of what we want the user to type. So we'll say shred Flanders. Pretty hilarious. Make sure you like and subscribe. And then we can test that this value is in that input. So we'll do expect username input to have value. We'll say shred Flanders. Save that and run the test. Test passed. So far we have grabbed the input, typed in the input, and verified the input. Then we want to grab the login button and click login button and check that username is displayed. So to grab the login button, you can use another thing called getByRole. GetByRole lets you grab elements by their ARIA roles and also gives some implicit roles to HTML elements, like the button, for example. The role would be button. And the cool thing about getByRole is if you pass it something that's not there, it will suggest to you items that do have a role. So if we do getByRole and send in an empty string, see, it gives us our main tag, a text box, which is the input, and the ID of the input is username, which is why it says the name username. So you do getByRole, you do text box, and then a comma, and then an object name, where name is the key and username is the value, and a role of button with the name of login. So we'll do a getByRole button. We'll do a name of login. Make sure we're grabbing that right. With the debug. And we're getting that button. So let's do a const login button. Now we want to click that button. This will be another user event. You can probably guess it. That'll be a click event. Pass in the login button because that's what we want to click. And now lastly, I've been showing you getByText and getByRole. There's also a findByText, which we'll need here. And so getByText allows you to grab things that are on the document. But if you want to grab things that will be on the document, you'll have to do findByText. And you'll also have to await that, because since it's not on the document, it's going to be asynchronous because you'll have to wait for it to be on the document. So we actually have to turn this whole function into an async function. And then you'll just do expect, we'll do await findByText. And that greeting was hi shred Flanders, and we'll expect that to be in the document. So with all that put in place, we'll save it, run the test again, and it passed. So this is a good real-world example of testing a component exactly how a user would use it. You know, you're grabbing the input, you're typing into the input, you're clicking on things, you're changing the screen, and then asserting that whatever has changed on the screen is there. I'll do another more in-depth video where we can mock fetching data and use that as well, but wanted to give you the basics, and this should give you plenty to work with. One more thing I want to show you though before I let you go is we did getByText and we did findByText. But there's one more, and that's queryByText. So getByText is to grab things that are on the document at the start, and it will give you an error if it's not there because it can't find it. FindByText is when you're testing on something that will be in the document and wait for that to be there, and then it'll test it. QueryByText is something that you can use to test if something is not on the document. Like if you want to grab an object and assert, you know, to be null or something, you can't do that with getByText because if it's not there, it'll just give you an error. You can't test that it's not there. So QueryByText is what you would use for that. And let's see, we used getByText, getByRole, getByLabelText, and then there's also getByPlaceholder. Text, get by alt text, and get by display value. And you can use these with the get by or find by or query by. Okay, well, that's a very good chunk of React testing library. Hope it helped you out. If it did, maybe hit that like button. And if you're feeling crazy, you know, maybe even hit the subscribe button. You only live once. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Check it, check it.